Hello everyone. Today we'll talk about another applications of equation of motion. During last lessons, we derived the most general form of equation of motion and we use it in uniform motion. Now it's time for vertical projection. So we have two balls, the first and the second. The initial distance between these balls is h equal to 200 meters. And in the same moment, we throw these balls vertically, the first ball downward with velocity v1. Magnitude of this velocity is 20 meters per second. And the second ball we throw upward with velocity v2. Magnitude of this velocity is equal to 80 meters per second. So that it was easier to calculate, we'll assume that gravitational acceleration g is equal 10 meters per second square. In this task, we want to know where and when these balls will meet. To solve this problem, we use equation of motion. I'll remind you the most general form of equation of motion. It is here. Usually here we write x and here x, but we named our axis h, so here is h and here is h. We have to know the meaning of h0, v0 and a. So h0 is coordinate of initial position of the body. V0 is coordinate of initial velocity vector. I should remind you what does it mean. The coordinate of the vector is equal to plus magnitude of the vector if vector is directed the same as axis, or minus magnitude of vector if vector is opposite to the axis. And a is coordinate of acceleration vector, and the same here, if coordinate of acceleration vector is equal to plus magnitude of acceleration vector, or minus if the vector is directed the same as axis, or minus magnitude of acceleration vector if this vector is opposite to the axis. Now we can write equation of motion for first and second body. Before we do it, we should draw also acceleration vectors for first and the second body. We know from the second Newton's law of motion that acceleration vector is directed the same as resultant force. Here the only acting force on the first and the second body is a gravitation force. It is directed downward, and the same is the direction of acceleration vector, A1 and A2. We know from the second Newton's law of motion that magnitude of acceleration vector is equal magnitude of resultant force divided by a mass. In this task, we assume that in frame of reference connected with surface of Earth is inertial frame of reference, and we can replace force of gravity by weight, and weight is equal to mass multiplied by g, gravitational acceleration, if we divide weight, this is mass times gravitational acceleration by mass, mass will cancel and will achieve g. So in both cases, a magnitude of acceleration for the first and the second body is equal to gravitational acceleration g. So now we can write equations of motion for the first and the second body. Let's start. H1 equals to initial coordinate of position of the first body. Let's see, here is the first body, and initial coordinate of position is equal to h. It's h because we choose the initial position of initial coordinate of position for the second body to zero. Zero plus h equals to h. Next, here is minus because velocity vector v1 is opposite to the axis h, so its coordinate is equal to minus magnitude of this vector minus v1 times delta t. We can here write also t. It is often used in this place. When we can replace delta t by t, if both bodies begin to move in the same moment, then we can write instead of delta t t, and it will be equally good. We see that the first body changes its velocity, so we have acceleration vector, and we see that acceleration vector is also opposite to the axis, so here we have minus. Because coordinate of acceleration vector m1 is equal to minus magnitude of this vector minus a1 and is equal to g, the gravitational acceleration. So here we have minus g multiplied by delta t squared divided by 2. We have the first equation of motion for the first body, then we write equation of motion for the second body. Initial coordinate of position for the second body is equal to 0, so here we have 0. Velocity vector initial velocity vector v2 is directed the same as axis h, so its coordinate is positive and is equal to plus magnitude of this vector. So here we have plus v2, where v2 is magnitude of initial velocity vector v2. We see that acceleration vector a2 is opposite to the axis, so its coordinate is negative and is equal to minus magnitude of this vector. This is minus g, so here is minus g times delta t squared divided by 2. So we have equation of motion for the second body. And equations of motion allow us to find a coordinate of position of the body in any moment. If we know magnitude of initial velocity, and we know magnitude of acceleration, and we put here the time that elapsed from the beginning of the motion, then we'll have the knowledge where we'll find this body on the axis h. Now we want to know where and when these balls will meet. And we know that in the moment when they meet, they will be in the same place. So, H1 equals to H2. We put, instead of H1 and H2, right sides of these equations. It's done here. Instead of H1, we put that expression. Instead of H2, we put this expression. We see that this last expression will cancel if we change sides of this equation, and we can change form of this equation to such, and can transform this to this form and calculate delta t. We know height, we know magnitudes of velocities, so we put here, and we know now that these balls will meet after 2 seconds. If we want to know where these balls will meet, it is enough to put this value to first equation or to the second equation, and it's done here. To the first equation, we instead of delta t here and here, we put 2 seconds. 2 seconds squared is 4 seconds c squared. And we see that we achieve the same value. After 2 seconds, these balls met, so they were in the same place. So coordinate of position of both bodies was the same. So now we can solve any problem similar to that. I mean, when we are throwing two bodies vertically, only if we know velocity vector v1, v2, and acceleration vector, and if we know what sign to write here and here. And I remind you that V0 and A are coordinates of vectors, so they can be positive or negative. They are positive if vector V0 or A is directed the same as axis, or are equal to minus magnitude of vector if V0 or acceleration vector are directed opposite to the axis. So we solved our problem. It's all for today. But I remind you that you can find other lessons on the playlist named Kinematics and Dynamics. There is also one more playlist with lessons recorded in English. It's named Special Theory of Relativity. That second playlist contains all lessons recorded in English. So, it's the end of this lesson.